profile in the local community around health and wellness. And again, he has his approach. You know, as we've talked about, many of these presenters have various approaches. There's not exactly one right way all the time. There's things that are variations about your lifestyle or your personality or your body type or your ethnic history. So everybody's different. Today we have Dr. Bob DeMaria, who's going to talk about his philosophy in his approach to wellness and detoxification. So he also has a number of lectures. You could actually go to his website. He'll talk about that also. And if there's any topic that you're particularly interested in, he's got a whole slew of videos on there that you can also watch. So without any delay, I'm going to turn over to Dr. Bob.
Thank you, and thanks for coming today. First, I want to congratulate you, because you know what? You're in healthcare just like I'm in healthcare. And you have a global impact, and it's probably more important now than any other time in history. I've been practicing since 1978, and I communicate with people around the world because of the internet. And as Sal was saying, that I do have a website which I'll give to you with a brochure, and I have a lot of videos. My passion and my purpose to be here today is to educate you so you have a better understanding of what health is and what health is not. And I've been really blessed to have written several books. This is a book that just came out this year. It's on detoxification. And everybody always asks me, well, Dr. Bob, what do I do? What herb do I take? What do I do for this? What do I do for that? And I'm going to tell you one of the most common responses I give to everybody. Have to stop putting in your body, which is causing the toxins in the first place. And as Americans, what we want to do is we want to have our cake and eat it too. Well, if you keep on eating cake, what's going to happen to you, not only will you have a greater chance to become a potential diabetic, it could actually cause your left neck and shoulder blades to hurt, which hopefully over the next several months we'll be able to talk about that. So you have some notes there. And detoxification for your company. What causes a toxic state? And I wrote down two things, physical and emotional. Now, one of the most important organs in the body when it comes to detoxification is this. This is a Fram oil filter. Now, I've been practicing for a long time, and back in the good old days, and some of you with gray hair will know, they used to have an advertisement that said, you pay me now, or you pay me later. Well, yesterday, in the USA Today, there was a very frightening statistic. The statistic was this. Every 70 seconds in America, somebody is diagnosed with a condition. You want to know what that condition is? Alzheimer's. Now, the last thing in the world you ever want to do is attract Alzheimer's, because that goes across all socioeconomic bounds. You know, Ronald Reagan didn't know the difference between what a tree was and rocky at the end of his life. All of it is preventable. And so what you do here at Vitamix, you create a fine product that helps take away something out of the body if they use your product correctly. It's called inflammation. Inflammation is what causes so many health challenges. Well, this is the liver. The liver is right here in your body. A lot of times people get confused where the liver exactly is at. It's right here, right underneath your ribcage on the right-hand side. When people have anger, they can have liver distress. All of you are, I'm sure, familiar with Christopher Reeves and his wife. Well, Christopher Reeves, unfortunately, had a major accident, lived for many years. But soon after he passed away, guess who passed away? His wife. In my practice, what I have found, anytime that somebody has major stress in their bodies, eventually they're going to succumb to cancer. Why? Because this liver is affected by emotions. I have a degree in natural health. I also have a degree in chiropractic, a degree in human biology. Not to impress you, I take this very serious. A fellowship in spinal engineering. And I have my diplomate status in chiropractic orthopedics. I'm going to flip you out right now. What you eat can cause pain. What you eat can take away pain. What you eat can cause inflammation in your body. How you feel, there's a part of your brain called the hypothalamus. That would be a test question, by the way, if you're taking the test right now. The hypothalamus connects the physical man to the emotional man. If I was to tell you really a sad story right now, you get that pit in your stomach, it's because of the hypothalamus. Well, if you have pits in your stomach day in and day out, over time, your immune system will get weak. When I was studying for my natural health certification, when you're under stress, your white blood cells stop working. They are paralyzed. They're handcuffed. So your emotions affect your health. Physically, what happens to you when you eat food, it could cause a toxic state inside of your body. That is going to affect your overall toxins in your life. Now, what I want to do, because I know our time is limited, is I send out a tip in my practice every week. I send out a tip on Fridays. It's a health tip. And I know that some of you may get them already, but if you like to receive my tips every week, just sign your name on this, print clearly and legibly, and in about 2 or 3 weeks, you'll start receiving our tips. And I know that it'll make a huge impact in your life. Okay. What are the detoxifying organs in your body? Well, I have a whole list of a bunch of them right there. One of them is a sluggish colon. Now, my purpose today is to stretch your brains to think different. Not physiologically incorrect, but I need you to think a little bit different than what you ever have before. If you have a sluggish colon, now what's a sluggish colon mean? It means when you get done eating, within an hour or two, you should have a bowel movement. Now some people might have a bowel movement every 2 or 3 days. That's not healthy. If you have a sluggish colon, I would first encourage you to drink more water. How much water? Everybody in this room should drink at least a minimum of a quart of water every day. A minimum of a quart. The next thing you would do wisely is to add fiber to your diet. What kind of fiber? Broccoli, cabbage, cauliflower. Now, I really promote people to eat more vegetables than fruit. I can tell you from my experience that in America today, most people have a very stressed pancreas. I do not encourage bananas, raisins, and grapes. Bananas, raisins, and grapes will cause your neck to hurt on the left side of your body. Pears, plums, and apples are by far the best fruit to eat. Vegetables could be raw, but not just raw. You want to steam your vegetables also, because you have to have something for the colon to grab onto. So you're going to have peristalsis. Now, you may not know this, but one of the most important glands in your body to improve colon function is your thyroid gland. If your thyroid gland is sluggish, you could pray for poop and it won't come out. I'm just telling you. Because I know that people in my office, and they're great Christians, and they're praying to go to the bathroom, and I have to motivate them to drink water and eat vegetables. How do you know if you have a low thyroid gland or not? Well, besides having blood tests, which we do in our office, if you have cold hands and cold feet, cold hands and cold feet are very common reasons to have our common body symptoms of a low thyroid gland. And we're not, my purpose today is not to talk about low thyroid, it's to make it impress you that that could be an issue. Go to my website, which I'll give it to you, www.druglessdoctor.com. Druglessdoctor.com. And watch the 3 10-minute videos that I have on iodine. So, I encourage our patients, and I'm going to jump ahead a little bit, to my 3 favorite foods that will make a huge difference in your body. If you add these to your life, I will guarantee you, you will be happy campers. This is going to help your bowels move. These are Dr. Bob's ABCs. I'm going to go down in history after I won the Nobel Prize as being the world-renowned leader of the ABCs, of course, the vitamins. So I'll be in front of the vitamins with my pose. Everybody in this room, are you listening to me? Say yes.
Yes.
All of you should be eating at least a half an apple every day. At least a half apple every day. And I know someone's thinking, why a half an apple, Dr. Bob? Well, one apple has 22 grams of carbs in it. So I want you to eat at least a half of a red apple every day. Why not a green apple? I have nothing against green apples. But in my studies, I had to take a class in aphoretic medicine. Don't ever ask me to spell aphoretic medicine. I have to go to Wikipedia and copy and paste it. It's really a strange spelling. But anyways, in my studies in aphoretic medicine, I had to read some books, a lot of books. Well, they talk about in Indian medicine, your colon is critical for optimal health. Green apples, Granny Smith's, will stagnate digestion. Stagnant. When you wake up tomorrow morning, you have a very simple test you can do. When you wake up, you have a thick, pasty tongue. It's called AMA, A-M-M-A. That tells me you're toxic. If you eat a half a red apple every day, guess how much you can lower your cholesterol? 13%. That's pretty good, you know. 13%, half an apple every day. Now, This is one of my favorite foods in the whole planet, and I know everybody in this room, hello, should know what this is.